Hey guys, it's Real. Welcome to another Nerdy Nummies. Today I have a very special guest, it's Sophie Dossie!
What's up, guys?
I am so excited. This is the first time that we have ever baked before. If you guys are not familiar or you haven't checked out her channel, go check it out now. I'm gonna put a link down below. Subscribe, show her some love. She is amazing. And if someone wasn't familiar with the videos over on your channel, what would we find?
I'd say a lot of bendy stuff, contortion-y stuff.
Yes.
And a lot of weird challenges.
Yes.
Involving tricks and stunts.
She is amazingly talented. I have never seen contortion like this ever. Also, we filmed a video over on her channel where we are baking, but we're not using our hands. So I'll put a link down below to that. So go check that out as well. Okay, so what's your baking skill level? Beginner, intermediate, advanced.
Beginner.
What do you feel? Like in the beginner?
In the beginner.
Okay, this is a really cute cake that we're making today. A while ago, I made a Moana cake with my friend Rebecca, and I asked you guys, what other Disney princess would you like to see us make? And boom, so many requests for a Belle cake. And we're gonna be using the pan from my baking line. If you wanna try out the princess pan, I'll put a link down below.
Let's get started.
So the first step is we're gonna mix everything together. I'm gonna be putting all of the ingredients and their measurements in the description down below. Okay, so Sophie, the first thing is mixing together the dry ingredients.
Okay.
So you're gonna pour in the baking powder and salt into the flour, then whisk together until well combined. Yeah, you got it. Work all that in there.
I'm baking a cake, Mom.
Yeah, proud. We're proud. All right, now that you've whisked together all the dry ingredients, we're gonna mix together all the wet ingredients and our sugar over here. I'm gonna have you pour in the sugar.
Okay.
And I'm gonna add the eggs. There's a bunch of eggs.
That's a lot of sugar.
Don't worry, this is not just for one cake. It's three cakes all in one.
I mean, I would take all that sugar for just one cake.
Then you're gonna add your vanilla and lemon extract. This recipe is so good. It's a yellow cake recipe, and it is made perfectly for the princess cake pan. So if you're at home and you wanna use any other cake recipe, feel free, but we're just using one that was perfectly made for the pans. Then using the electric hand mixer, mix together for about 2 to 3 minutes till it's well combined. Sophie, I'm gonna have you do this. Are you ready?
Oh, okay. I've never done this, so.
Okay, just click it one up.
Oh, whoa.
Yes, 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 yes. You're baking, you're baking. All right. All right, I'm gonna spin this around. And we just wanna keep mixing, get those yolks, break them up, and then you can move it up one more click, go to a medium speed. Crank it up, crank it up, crank it up. Okay, that's good then. Just shut it off like this. And whatever you do, don't hit this button.
What's this button?
This button will shoot your little beaters out.
Okay, right, go for it.
Oh, only one came out.
That was pretty cool though.
So that's what that button does. The last step, we're gonna mix our dairies together. We're gonna add the buttermilk, milk, and melted butter.
Ooh, oh, whoops, I spilled
there
a little
we
bit.
Go. No, that's okay, that's okay. We have plenty of dairy, don't worry, there's plenty to spare. And then I'm just gonna mix together till well combined. You guys, baking pro over here, I think that you don't have to say you're a beginner anymore. I think you can definitely say intermediate. We're moving up a level today.
I moved up to intermediate.
Yeah, that's right.
Watch out, Rosanna.
Watch
coming,
out. Coming for
coming
this brand.
For
come for
brand.
It any day. If anyone would like to come for my brand, please. I would love to go on vacation. You're doing great. Just keep going. Okay, I'm back. We have all of our mixtures. We have our egg mixture, we have our flour mixture, and our buttermilk mixture. So you're gonna start with your dry, and we're gonna add it to the egg. We're gonna add the whole thing. Sophie, can you help me scoop this in there?
Boom.
Ta-da! Now you're gonna mix this together until it's well combined. Start slow, because if you start fast, it will poof, do a big dust cloud. That's perfect. And then you just work it together, and you can use a spatula to occasionally scrape down the sides. So I'll scrape down while you mix. Once it's mixed, add the butter and milk. And is it go?
Yeah,
okay.
It's going in.
Geez.
It's going in.
Oh, jeez. This bowl is so full. Okay, be really careful. All right, then just keep mixing. Oh, sorry. I should get you an apron. Oh my gosh, do you need one?
No, I'm
okay.
Good.
This looks so crazy. Okay, our batter is all ready. Sophie did a great job. Look at this. It looks and smells delicious. Now we're just gonna eyeball it and divide it between these three pans. And these three pans are what's inside this box. So you don't have to get three different boxes. All three are in one. They like stack together. So just pour the batter around, but not in the middle, in the hole. Because these are kind of shaped like bundt pans, where there's a hole in the middle, and that's because I've measured it to be the perfect size for like a standard doll. Okay, you start pouring, and we'll put like a third. Okay.
Is that too much?
I got it. Okay. We did it. Okay, this one, more in here. And then the third one. Oh my gosh, this is so great having someone to help. When I have to do this on my own, I almost drop it all the time. Okay, even out. Whatever one you think's a little lacking. Your baking skill level is increasing as we're hanging out right now.
So like what level am I now?
Beginner's like a one.
Beginner's
or three.
A one, yeah.
Yeah.
So what's intermediate?
I think like a five.
A five? Ooh.
Yeah. You're like at a 5-6 right now. I think.
Ooh.
Like this is pretty
I'm
good.
I'm stepping it up,
look
guys.
At you. Boom. We've got all of yeah, boom.
Kapow.
Kapow. Chop. We've got all of the batter into the pans. Now you're gonna heat your oven to 350 degrees and bake for about 35 minutes. And what's really cool about this is you can put all the cakes in the oven at the same time.
So our cakes are baked, mm-hmm. and we gave it time to cool, and now we're gonna assemble them.
Yes, and you wanna give them time to cool. It makes them easier to work with. They aren't as crumbly. We've leveled them, so they have a little crumbs everywhere, but they will be falling apart if you try to do this while they're still like warm.
Yeah.
So you wanna let them cool first. I have a little cake plate, but you can use whatever you wanna serve your cake on, and I'm placing it on top of a turntable, and this is just gonna make it easier for us to frost. Because even if you're an advanced baker, they still use these. So don't be offended. This isn't like a training wheel that I'm giving you. This is like the pros use these.
Oh, so now we're using what the pros
Yeah. Use. Oh, yeah. We're taking it up a notch. Okay, ready for this? I'm going to put a little frosting down on the cake plate. Boop, 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 so that it will just like stay in place. And then take the big one and place it right on top. Don't worry about the extra icing. I'll just eat it. And then to assemble the cake, we're going to go cake, frosting, cake. Wait a minute. Cake?
Cake?
Frosting.
Frosting,
frosting,
cake, frosting, cake,
cake, frosting, cake,
frosting, cake,
frosting, cake,
frosting,
cake,
frosting.
You guys know what we're saying? All right, so to do this, I'm gonna show you, is you pipe an outline all the way around. It's kind of like a fence, just like that, and then you fill it in. And you don't wanna go skimpy on the icing. You want a good layer so that when you cut into the cake, you get that really pretty slice of cake that's like cake, frosting, cake, frosting. And then you spin it around. So using a small offset spatula, you're just gonna be really gentle and just you're putting gentle pressure down. And as you go around, you can put more and more pressure. All right, are you ready to do this?
Yeah, I'm ready.
Okay, so you put on the next layer right on top. First, pipe an outline around the outside, like a little fence.
This is really satisfying.
I wouldn't say that it's better than slime. That's hard to compete with. Like,
I mean,
slime is so
this
satisfying.
Is, but like, but slime's been done, you know?
I just got an idea with you here.
What?
This is what happens when two creative people hang out. A slime cake. Has it even been done?
I don't think that has been done.
I've never seen one. This is pretty advanced here. So just put a little gentle pressure and just kind of spin it around like this. Oh my gosh. You guys are seeing this? Are you seeing this? Sophie's also a baking pro. She just didn't tell anybody. She's been just, this is another one of her little talents. She's just been hiding away.
You know, I'm coming for your career.
Take it. Let's be honest. The more bakers out there, the better.
Is so, this it?
That looks really good. And it's so even. Boom, you just got another baking point.
Boom.
You're up to 7 baking points
Dang.
Now. Top layer. Just right on top. And now this is a perfect height if you've got a standard doll, like a Barbie or something. But if you have a doll that's a little bit taller or shorter, you can adjust the height by how much frosting you put in between the layers. If you need it to be a little bit taller, add a little bit more frosting. And if you've got a shorter doll, like they make shorter Barbies now, like my size ones, put a thinner layer. Now that the cakes are assembled, we're gonna ice the outside of the cake in a piping bag. I have so much icing. We were joking about how much icing this is.
But a lot.
Seriously, this is to ice 3 cakes. I'm gonna need your help. If you'll slowly spin, just start icing at the bottom of the cake. Press it against the cake so it'll stick and just work your way around. So you ice like a ring around the bottom and then build your way up. It doesn't need to look perfect because we're gonna cover the cake with fondant, so you don't need to worry if there's any imperfections. So look how funny this looks. It looks kind of like a beehive. Now you just take your offset spatula like we did before and you gently press right here, and then if you wanna spin it around, but just put really gentle pressure because it's really hard to put more icing on the cake and make it look good. So if you're just gently doing this, and you can spin it around as many times as you need to make it as smooth as you want. And also remember again, this one does not need to look perfect because we're gonna cover it in fondant. And if you have any little spots, you can just boop, boop, fill it in. Okay, are you ready to do this?
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, I'll let you like spin it because then you have a little bit more control.
Okay, that's okay. I think cool. That's good.
So we just finished icing and smoothing the cake, and now we're about to put the fondant on.
Yes. Have you ever worked with fondant before?
No.
Okay, so it's kind of like edible Play-Doh. It's very thick icing.
Oh, wow.
So it's just a lot of sugar.
Yeah.
And as it sits out longer, it will harden. So right now it's pliable. I rolled out some yellow fondant, and this is the largest, like, it's for fondant. It's like a rolling pin for fondant.
So you roll it onto it?
Yeah. So if you want to roll it onto it, just be really gentle. It doesn't need to be tight or perfect. Just like do 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 do. Okay, we're gonna pick it up. We're gonna transfer it over here, and we're just gonna let it rip right over the top.
Ooh! Whoa!
Perfect! And you'll stick it to the side of the cake and then gently pull down. And you'll do this all the way around. Just gentle, gentle, gentle. Okay, so we got the fondant over the cake. Check this out all the way around. And because we want her dress to look like fabric, usually I'd like pull it tight against the cake and we do like a fancy little border, but this looks like a dress. So we're just gonna, if you want more little like grooves, you can just pull them, make them more like lifted, but this is the look that we're going for. So I think it's really cool. So for a beginner, like if you're making this cake, just put it over the top and how it falls naturally, looks like a dress.
So we set our cake off to the side and we got our Barbie doll.
Oh my gosh, she's so cute.
What are we gonna do?
This part is a little rated PG-13. Shield your eyes. We have to take off Belle's dress.
We'll cover her.
Okay, yeah. We're gonna keep her gloves on because I didn't make those. Oh, she does have undies.
She has undies, but not a top on.
All right, she'll just stand like this.
Yeah.
This is fine. All right, so this is the first shape that we're gonna place on her. How cute, right? A little top.
It's a little.
It's not quite my size. But you know, it's all right. A little bit of water on a paintbrush. We're just gonna paint it on the back side of the fondant. Water is basically like fondant adhesive. She has a tattoo on her back. Belle!
Belle!
Belle's got a tattoo!
She has a tattoo.
Oh, scandalous!
Who knew?
Okay, and then I'm gonna wrap it around. Okay. And like cover up her tattoo in the back.
Yeah.
And then I'm gonna press it against her. We're learning how to bake and we're learning Disney secrets today. The second strip of fondant is just one little line and then I've cut little grooves at the end. You can use a knife or like some scissors, whatever you want to give detail. And then put her arms down because it's an off the shoulder look. And you're gonna put this piece, the smooth part in the back and the little cut pieces in the front. And I'm gonna take a little bit of water on top of the corset, and you just stick it on, and then you can do the same on the other side. Have them attach in the middle. Yes, get
there
together.
There we go.
And then this part's totally optional, but I've rolled three little balls of fondant right here just for a little detail, doing the bigger ball in the middle, and then two smaller ones on the side. Just squish it on there.
There we go.
Oh my gosh, I love it. Okay, here's two more. Boom. There's no exact science to this, so I'm just taking a sharp object. This is a fondant cutting tool, but you can use a knife or just like the end of your little paintbrush. Just something to break the tension right in the middle of the cake. There's a big hole because it's kind of like a bundt cake. And we're just gonna do this just to get it started. It's normal if it cracks around the edges a little bit. That's okay. Now you're just gonna slowly and carefully, oh, I'm gonna take off her shoes.
Yeah, take off her shoes.
Come here, girl. And just slowly place her down into the middle. Perfect. Next, I've got some more fondant shapes. This one's really cute. It's like a little belt. And it comes to a point. And this is gonna go in the front of her dress, connecting the top of her dress to the bottom. And what's nice about fondant, and if you don't like something, you can just reshape it and make it look however you'd like. And then the final details are those cute little like sashes all the way around her dress. So classic. It's her ball gown dress. It's when she's dancing with Beast and it's like really romantic. They're like, da, 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 da. Da, 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 da,
here we
go. Da, da, da. Oh, how do you do this? Da, 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 da. Da, 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 da. Yes, we want those vibes.
Yeah.
So to make these, it's really easy. I rolled like a little log of fondant, pew pew pew, and then cut them into small little sections. And then to get these lines, I use basically a mini pizza cutter. Doesn't this look like a little, it's almost like Barbie size. Like it's like if she was gonna cut a piece of pizza.
It would be this.
Yeah. It's so cute, and just went pew and made little lines. And then I let them sit out to dry. I made these in advance because I wanted them to be really firm, so they needed to sit out for a few hours. And I was like, I don't wanna invite you over and then have you have to wait on some fondant for hours. So we made these in advance. And then you're just gonna stick them on the cake like Sophie's doing all the way around. I like to put them about like in the middle of the dress, and to get them to attach to the cake like Sophie's doing, what are you doing? A little bit of water?
You put a little bit of water. I think it's really cool that like you can just stick water on it and it just sticks to it.
It loves it. The sugar is like, oh yeah. I think you're getting another point because you just learned something.
An eight?
Yeah.
Ooh.
Okay, so right here, this was the last piece and it was a little bit smaller. That's fine. What you can do is you can just cut off a little bit and however big it is, you can make it fit. Boom, look at that. Oh my gosh, she's like, yes. Oh, we're gonna add these little balls for details. So these are just little fondant balls that we've rolled. And again, using the water, just attach them to the dress. I'm gonna place three of them in between each little sash wave.
Ta-da!
Here is the Princess Belle cake that we made today. A big thank you to you all for suggesting this cake. And a big thank you to Sophie for helping me bake today. She did so good. I was so impressed by you.
Okay, this is my first cake I made that actually looks good.
Oh my gosh. She is so sweet and so talented. I'm gonna be putting all of her links down below. Go check her out, show her some love, subscribe. And also, I'm gonna be putting a link down below to the video we made together on her channel. So go click over there, check it out. We baked with no hands. No hands.
No hands.
Okay? It was very fun and very messy.
Yeah.
I'll also be putting the recipe down below in the description. And let me know what other nerdy nummies you'd like to see me bake. All right, I hope you guys enjoyed it. Bye-bye.